Hey guys, David Kwan here. Today I want to talk about something that's really bothersome about the internet, and it's a trend that's been continuing on, and so now we have this current state in the internet culture where things are this way, and it's really bothersome to me. When internet first started, it was kind of a gateway to accessing information anywhere and everywhere. You know, I was in California, but I could learn about a wedding event in Paris, France. And same thing, you know, with a person in France being able to learn about what, you know, somebody's opinion on abortion was in Africa. You know, internet connected us to all kinds of information that was out there. And anyone could freely access all of that as long as they had an internet connection. That's how it started out. But now it's a really different picture. It's a different picture because some things like Facebook, Twitter, Google search engine, Bing, I don't even know if Altavista is big anymore, but Altavista, MSN, BuzzFeed, stuff like these, and YouTube, of course, have become gigantic search engines that are the gatekeepers to information. Even something like Wikipedia, for example, although Wikipedia not so much. The problem is, behind every one of these kind of search engines is a computer algorithm program. And these algorithms try to guess what it is that we like. And it tries to guess by judging what we click on. So let's say I really am interested in celebrity gossip and celebrity news and entertainment news. And usually when I get online, let's say that I tend to click a lot on celebrity gossip news. Well then, this algorithm tracks that click. So it tracks whatever I click on, and it tries to determine what it is I like. And it tries to feed me information that I would find comfortable, that I would find interesting, that I would really like. And this is great. This is in concept, it's really great. It's the personalized algorithm, and the computer is able to guess what it is that you like without even, you know, before you even complete the search. You know, you type three letters in, the computer already knows what you want to search for. That's the motive behind this algorithm. The problem is that with this, you don't get information that might challenge your views. There's less and less likelihood of that. You don't get information that might make you uncomfortable, that might shock you, that might surprise you, that might, you know, get you out of your comfort zone, because it's not something that you would be interested in reading. You know, before the internet, we had newspapers and whatnot, you know, that we had to get information from. The thing about those was the gatekeepers were the journalists and editors. They decided what was on there. You got that, and you by reading the newspaper, sometimes you would be reading stuff that is just like, well, this guy is totally wrong. I do not agree with this at all. This view is like really uncomfortable. It's really like it has evidence against what I currently believe in, you know. Shock, like uncomfortable things that challenge your views, it happened because whatever they wrote was not totally guesstimating on what you believed in. But the internet is actually pretty accurate with its algorithms. And the danger is that people see only the stuff that will affirm their beliefs, that doesn't challenge their views. The problem with this, the danger of this, the ultimate danger, is that we have a society that is divided in extremes. You know, people who tend to be liberal will only get more things that have liberal bias in them. People who tend to be conservatives will get information that are more conservative. And so you start having groups that are extremes, extreme liberals, extreme leftists, who become more and more and more extreme. Extreme conservatives who become more and more and more rightists, right-wing. And that's dangerous. When you have these groups of people who cannot come to agreement with each other because they are so far removed from the opposition side's view, is dangerous. And this is a big topic, and this is probably a topic that I will want to address in a future video. In this video, to keep it under 10 minutes, hopefully, to keep this as short as I can, I know I'm a wordy guy, I just want to focus on YouTube for this video. And I think YouTube is an important topic to talk about, especially about its comment section. I totally disagree with how comments are you know, what happens to the comments after you type them out. It's in a way because of the system in place, what ends up happening is that we end up censoring ourselves, and it really, really bothers me. The first thing I want to talk about is downvoting. You know, I think it's a good idea to be able to, you know, give a comment a thumbs up or give a comment thumbs down, based on, you know, maybe the comment was really brilliant, or maybe the comment was something that you believed in. Maybe the comment made you laugh. Great, give it a thumbs up. Maybe the comment was racist. Maybe the comment was homophobic. Maybe the comment just is, you know, you're a religious person and this person commented something that offended your religion, and so you don't like it. All right, give it a thumbs down. I don't have a problem with this specific concept. What I have a problem with is the concept that if you get enough downvotes, if you get enough thumbs down, that comment is now becomes hidden. So again, this is where society determines, you know, what information is available and what information is not. This is super dangerous, because even though, you know, maybe you don't want to see an offensive comment, maybe you don't want to see a racist comment, maybe you don't want to see a stupid, ridiculous comment, but the fact is, you need to. It's not whether you want to or not. It needs to be on there. It shouldn't be censored. So that is the problem where we are ultimately, accidentally maybe, censoring ourselves. I have no issue with, you know, putting the highest rated comment at the top, you know, making it the most visible, whatever. But don't hide it. Don't hide comments. Don't make me have an extra effort to go click this show link, show comment button, because it's just wrong to me. That kind of censorship is, again, it will create a society in which we have these extreme opposites or just extremes of groups. You only end up reading things that affirm your beliefs, that doesn't challenge you. The second thing, and this is more on us, this is not a YouTube policy that I'm against. I'm totally against a YouTube policy that makes it so that if a comment gets enough thumbs down, that comment becomes hidden, and you have to click an extra link to see that comment. I am totally against that policy, and I wish sometime in the future YouTube changes this. Do an update where this isn't the case anymore. I really, 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 really wish that happens. The second thing I want to talk about, it's not a YouTube problem. It's us problem. With comments, we have the ability to mark certain comments as spam. What I see happening again is people who don't like that comment, whether it's spam or not, will mark something as spam. And I think this is horribly, horribly wrong. Because again, this is selective censorship by us. And it's also lying. It's being so totally dishonest. Alright, somebody calls me a chink. I think that's, you know, whatever. It's chink is a racist term, whatever. You know, it's a racist comment, sure. But I'm not going to mark it as spam, because it's not spam. It's just a racist, stupid comment. That's all it is. And I'll just leave it on there, because that person with that username now made himself look like a fool. I don't want it hidden. I want it there, just so people can read what this person thinks. It's important that we get different viewpoints and different, you know, we have this exchange where we see all viewpoints. It's really dangerous to censor ourselves in this manner. So sometimes I end up going on, you know, watching a video on YouTube, and I see a lot of comments, and I end up reading those comments. I'm just like, this is marked as spam, and I'm like, I click on to show this comment, and I read it, and it's like, this is not spam. And then so I click on not spam. And I end up doing this campaign where I'm just constantly going, not spam, not spam. Oh yeah, this person made a really stupid comment, but it's not spam. You know, this person made a super offensive comment, but not spam. Sometimes, I mean, there's a few times when I see the comment, it's like, go to this, you know, check out this, search this word on Google and go to this website and you get, you know, you could get $100 if you're the 100th customer on this website. Totally spam. And in that case, I leave that alone. It's like, yeah, that's spam. But if you're marking a comment as spam because you don't agree with it, because it offends you, because it's a stupid comment, you're worse than the person who made that comment. You're the one being dishonest. You're the one who's promoting censorship of YouTube. And that's really the point I want to make. The two points that are really important to me is that we shouldn't censor ourselves, and YouTube shouldn't censor us. Discussion is really important, especially views that challenge your own views. So YouTube, I really wish they removed this concept of you get enough comments, and your comment gets enough thumbs down, and that comment becomes hidden. A horrible idea. And to people who mark as spam comments that are not spam, just stop doing that, because it helps no one. It certainly doesn't help the person who made a racist or stupid comment either, because now their racism is hidden from view. So those are my two cents. Tell me guys what you think. I hope you enjoyed the video. Cheers.